All right, 我们接下来 next session. Person-centered trauma-informed family caregiving by Lily Liu, 以人为本创伤之情的照顾方法。我们的刘怡君女士，大家掌声谢谢。
Good afternoon, everyone. 大家好，我的中文名字是刘怡君。I'm Lily Liu, and I want to first thank Teacher Katie, because after you plan this type of conference, nobody will fall asleep when I'm talking. 以后办这种节目，一定要把 Katie 老师摆在我的前面，大家就不会睡着了。今天那个非常非常荣幸，谢谢 Amanda 能来跟乐活五十家在一起。I am so honored to be here today with Happy 50 Plus, especially seeing all of you dancing. It was so moving. 看到大家一起活动，好感动。今天为什么我想来？因为我是 1.5 代的华侨小孩子。I am a 1.5 generation Chinese American immigrant daughter. I am my mother's caregiver. 我是我的母亲的看护者。妈妈有巴金生病40年了。My mother has had Parkinson's for 40 years. 我们应该多谈一谈看护者的过程。今天我想来就是想介绍一个很有意思的看护的方法。I'm very honored to be here because it's very important for mental health to talk about the mental health of caregivers. 因为我是个看护者，我们心理健康是很重要一个题目。为什么我想来今天，就是因为我可以学那个犹太人，他们有一种方法。From the Jewish Federations of North America, I have learned something called person-centered trauma-informed care. 这个方法是很重要。我们应该从别的社区学习。We need to learn from other communities. 今天因为我是很小就来美国了，我的中文不够好，可是我今天想试一试，请大家多多指教。I came to America when I was very young, so I want to challenge myself to deliver this also bilingually in Chinese and English. This thing called person-centered trauma-informed care, 它是以人为本创伤之情一种方法，非常非常重要，因为这个可以了解父母他们的那个 mental health, 他们的那个健康。所以这个犹太人他们这个方法是很有意思，因为他们那个第二次大战他们的那个幸存者 The Holocaust survivors, they use this for the trauma-informed care. 这个很重要，因为我们也可以学习，因为他们这种的方法令我可以学习当个看护者。By using the person-centered trauma-informed care, I now can be a better family caregiver for my mother. 我的父母的过程是逃难、流亡学生，后来去台湾，后来来美国以后，我们是住在一个没有太多中国人的州。So my parents left China as exiles, as refugees, left their hometown,And then when we immigrated to America, we lived in a state that did not have many Chinese people. 所以有四种的创伤。There's exile, there's being a refugee, there's being an immigrant, and also being part of a diaspora. 所以这个创伤这个方法是很有意思，因为这样子可以了解父母是流亡学生，后来他们是难民。再加上是移民来美国，离开我们祖国，再加上现在住在国外，我们是 diaspora, 是华侨。所以一转眼来了这么多年，父亲、母亲，父亲已经过世了，现在我是照顾母亲，她的照顾者。So in a blink of an eye, after immigrating to America, I am now the caregiver for the woman who cared for me.And 所以我就觉得用这个方法，创伤的方法，可以了解怎么更好照顾母亲。So by using the trauma-informed care framework, I now realize I can be a better caregiver for my mother. 第一，去看医生的时候，常常得填表，可是没有知道我们自己家人的 病情，还有只有父母的。So we have no medical history beyond our parents. 祖母、祖父都不知道他们的身体。再加上呢，要是父亲不谈这种创伤，那我们也不了解为什么他有的时候会很难过。So being unable to understand our parents' trauma, we don't really understand when they sometimes have depression. 再加上要是他们不愿意谈，那我们也不能勉强父母或是婆婆公公让他们谈。And then 当然这几年来这个歧视我们大家都受到这个。So in the past few years, this racial discrimination and the anti-Asian hate. 我常常觉得母亲的巴金森病是不是因为他们当难民的时候，他们是逃难到越南，后来被那个殖民地，法国殖民地，他们喷了 DDT。So I've often wondered if my mother's Parkinson's, 40 years now, was it because they were sprayed with DDT when they were in Yunnan, when they were in Vietnam, a colonial French colony, and they were sprayed with DDT. 所以这样子用这个创伤的方法去了解，我就觉得第一，我自己是一直想学中文，这样子可以父母好好的沟通。第二呢，也让妈妈多谈她的故事。So this trauma-informed care helped me understand that I should let my parents talk about their experiences. But in order to do that, I had to learn Chinese and then let them sort of vent so they can talk about their trauma. And then 最重要就是母亲喜欢写作，所以她出了一本书，她自己的回忆录。So a type of therapy for my mother was writing a book.And this is a copy of her book. 这本是连经出的，在台湾出的。So it's very hard because when you're a 1.5 generation immigrant child, you don't really understand the Chinese culture. 虽然我在家里有学那个，应该是有什么风俗啊，我知道应该有孝心，可是别的传统就不太了解，因为来美国来得太早了。So it's very hard. I understand the concept of filial piety.But in order to understand the Chinese traditions, that's so hard because I'm a 1.5 generation.
所以可能您家庭时候也有一些年轻的宝宝们，他们愿意跟您沟通，可是有没有语言？
So sometimes when you're trying to talk to the younger generation, you don't have the language, and that is a barrier.
所以我就自己可以说，当个看护者有很多损失。
Because of being a caregiver for my mother, there have been a lot of losses. 第一，我离开了工作很早。So as a result, I left my workplace early in order to care for my mother.
再加上还有很多影响，就是那个财务啊，还有心理的健康，有很多损失。可是应该是照顾父母。第二呢，还有很多那个压力，因为每一天得跟妈妈洗澡啊，很麻烦。再加上这几年疫情，大家都有社交的距离，所以很难。再加上这个疫情中，我得为了减少那个怎么说疫情进来。
So as a result of being afraid of the risk of infection, during the pandemic, I did not have anybody to come in to help me.
没有雇保姆，所以这三年来24小时7天都是我一个人照顾母亲。
So as a result, I was 24/7 the caregiver for my mother.
再加上我们在新闻上面看到大家歧视啊，还有这种情绪非常痛苦。
So during these past 3 years, also the increased anti-Asian hate, that is also a type of trauma,
也是一种创伤。再加上大家都有社交距离，大家都很觉得孤单，自己在家里觉得很孤单。可是呢，我自己觉得应该去突破这些问题。
So as a result, I said it's very important to be resourceful.
第一呢，我自己觉得那个可以在网上参加，所以非常非常谢谢乐活五十家这么多年的好的那个节目。
So as a result, because I was socially isolated, trying to keep my mother safe from the pandemic, we did a lot of things 线上 on the virtual platform, and I was so grateful for Happy 50 Plus and all the wonderful things that they made possible.
再加上我们应该好好去找很多很多免费的资料， For example, there are so many wonderful resources, the NIH, 好多免费的资料 free resources. 所以现在我是觉得我今天在这边可以跟大家在一起 because we're with such an illustrious audience today, I think it's very important to make two points. 我们中国人的社区第一可以说是服务不足第二那个资料根本都不够 So the problem with the Chinese American community is we're so underserved and under-resourced 我们应该怎么样呢大家应该增加有我们中国语言的资料 We must increase all these resources that are in Chinese 第二呢是不是可以再让乐活五十家办一些这种节目支持他们 Perhaps we could send more resources to something like 50+, Happy 50+, to have more of these important mental health resources to fight social isolation. 第三呢，是不是我们大家都当我们一种自己去当个 advocate, 自己去来鼓励大家好好的觉得心情健康是个很重要的一个题目。And then 第二，这个字 stigma,无灵应该大家是开放一点能谈不要觉得害羞 Don't be scared or be embarrassed of the stigma of mental health 所以今天因为好高兴可以跟大家在一起我带来一些小小的礼物请 Amanda 把那个袋子里面的东西给各桌子这样子等一下请大家在外面拿这些东西拍一些照片来到微信上面请传给大家So as a result, I think it's so important to fight stigma of mental health. Have fun, be together with your community. 等一下让 Amanda 在那个盒子里面带来大家拍些照片。所以谢谢大家今天有这个机会。Thank you so much for this opportunity to be with Happy 50+. Thank you.
Thank you so much. I like your Gen 1.5. I love your Mandarin. 你的中文好可爱。